Amen.
Amen.
Let somebody shout hallelujah.
May one person shout hallelujah.
Shake hands with one or two people and say, good morning, God bless you.
Make you shake hands with one or two persons and you say, good morning, oh God bless you.
And then you may please be seated.
I'm making a concern.
Mark chapter 8. The gospel according to St. Mark chapter 8. From verse 22 to 25.
Mark chapter 8 verse 22 go reach 25.
Mark chapter 8 from verse 22 to 25.
Mark chapter 8 verse 22 go reach 25.
And he cometh to Bethsaida.
And he called come Bethsaida.
And they bring a blind man unto him.
And they can carry one man when they see come meet him.
And besought him to touch him.
And they come to beg and say, I beg, oh God, may you touch this man when they see.
And he took the blind man by the hand and led him out of the town.
He can't hold the man for hand, he can't lead him come up from the town.
And when he has spit on his eyes,
he can't spit for this man's eyes.
And put his hands upon him.
He can't use the hand to touch the eye.
He asked him if he saw aught.
He can ask and say, you didn't see anything?
And he looked up and said, I see men as trees walking.
This blind man can't look up because they see people, they be like trees.
After that, he put his hands again upon his eyes.
After this one, he can't put his hand again for the man's eyes.
And made him look up.
He can't tell the man, say, look up.
And he was restored and saw every man clearly.
This man eye can't open well, well. Can't they see everybody clearly?
I have prayed that God will give me a passage that is not just a thanksgiving passage or message.
I don't pray, may God give me one Bible passage, why not be only just thanksgiving passage or message?
But a message that will ensure.
But a message when we say, go get that power.
That whatever may be your personal problems, they don't follow you to the new year.
So that any problem when we say you carry come, or what you get, you know, go follow you enter the coming year.
In this story, the Bible said they brought a blind man to Jesus.
For this story, the Bible tells us, say they carry one man when they see come meet Jesus.
And they ask Jesus Christ to please do something about this case.
And they come beg Jesus Christ, say, I beg, oh, do something about this man case. So.
And Jesus took this man by the hand, led him out of the city.
Jesus Christ, come on, hold this man, carry this man, come out from the city.
And then spit on his eyes and lay hands on him.
And later he can't spit for the man's eyes. He can't put his hand for the man's eyes.
And as the man, what can you see?
And he can ask the man, say, what do they see?
The man said, I saw men like trees walking about.
He said, they see people, they be like trees, and then they walk about.
So he touched him a second time. I said, what about now?
He can't touch him the second time. He said, okay, now, what do they see now?
And the man said, I can see everybody clearly now.
The man can't touch him, they see everybody well, well now.
Those of you who use open heavens for your morning devotion, I'm sure you read this passage last week.
When they use open heaven for their morning devotion, I believe say this passage one they talk about when I don't read them last week.
I'm going to bring to your attention 7 points quickly from this story.
I will bring 7 points out of this story
that is not necessarily in the open heavens that you read.
When are they the open heaven when we say you don't read last week?
Number one. They brought him.
They carried the man come.
Someone brought you to Jesus Christ.
Now, person I bring you, come meet Jesus Christ.
And you have a duty to bring others too.
You can't get the work to go bring other people, come meet Jesus Christ also.
That's the first point.
And the first point be that.
In John chapter 1, verse 40 to 42.
For John chapter 1, verse 40, go reach 42.
John chapter 1, verse 40 to 42.
John chapter 1, verse 40, go reach 42.
Andrew brought his brother Simon to Jesus Christ.
Andrew can't bring a brother on there called Simon, come meet Jesus Christ.
In John chapter 1, verse 45 to 46.
For John chapter 1, verse 45, go reach 46.
John 1, verse 45 to 46.
John 1, verse 45, go reach 46.
Philip brought Nathanael to Jesus Christ.
Philip, come bring Nathanael, come meet Jesus Christ.
Whoever brought you to Jesus Christ is your benefactor.
Any person when say, oh, bring you, come meet Jesus Christ, so that person is the person who will help you.
Whoever brought you to Jesus Christ had done a great thing for you.
That person when say, bring you, come meet Jesus Christ, they'll do better thing for your life.
Very, very great thing.
A better thing they'll do for you.
Whoever took you to a babalawo is your number one enemy.
Anybody when you carry go meet native doctor, that person will be your number one enemy.
But whoever brought you to Jesus Christ had done a great thing for you.
But anybody when you say, Lord, carry, you can't give Jesus Christ, that person does do better thing for your life.
Because if that fellow had not brought you to Jesus, you will not be saved.
Because if that person not carry, come meet Jesus Christ, you not go feel they saved.
And the Almighty God commanded that you should bring others.
And the Almighty God will tell us, more go outside, more bring other people, come meet Jesus Christ.
John 15. Verse 16.
For John chapter 15, verse 16.
John chapter 15, verse 16 says clearly.
John 15, verse 16, to say,
you have not chosen me, but I have chosen you.
He said, you know, you choose me, but I may choose you.
And I have ordained you that you may go. Bring forth fruit.
I don't command you, may you go bear fruit.
And that your fruit may abide.
May your fruit remain.
Then, whatever you ask the Father in my name, I do it for you.
And after then, anything when you ask my Father for my name, I go give you.
Somebody brought you, bring somebody else.
Now, person I bring you, come meet Jesus Christ. So make you also bring another person, come meet Jesus Christ.
One of the first lessons I learned when I came to this church is that those of you who have been saved, rise up for the salvation of others.
Once when we say I left for this church, when I first come, we say, everybody when they are saved, supposed to go outside, go bring other people when they are saved.
It is a duty.
Now your work be that.
Somebody brought you, bring someone else.
Now person I bring you, make you bring another person come, meet Jesus Christ.
If you have been saved all these weeks, don't let me say years, and you have not yet brought somebody else to Jesus Christ, you are a debtor.
If you don't get saved, and all this will not pass, not let me talk say yes, and you know what, if you bring one person, come give Jesus Christ, which means you owe God, be see.
You owe God, and you must begin to pay from now on.
You owe God, be see, and you supposed to be paid by now.
Number two. The man they brought was a blind man.
The man when they bring come, the man not they see.
He was physically blind.
This man not they see physically.
But do you know that we were all blind men when they brought us to Jesus?
When I know so, every one of us, they're blind. When we say they bring us, come meet Jesus Christ.
We may not be physically blind, but we were spiritually blind.
Our eyes not feel blind physically, but spiritually we not they see at all.
Before they brought us to Jesus Christ, we will be doing evil and we'll be enjoying it.
Before they come carry us, come meet Jesus Christ. We're going to do bad things and we'll see they enjoy them.
Sunday morning like this, you wake up with a headache.
Sunday morning, we'll wake up with one strong headache.
A hangover from the heavy drinking of last night.
The reason be saying that the drink when be saying you don't drink before, that last night before you sleep, now they worry you.
We look forward to Saturday night for party.
We will expect Saturday to come fast so that we feel go party.
And some of us who are highly placed, highly educated.
Many of us when we say be big man with their high position, and when we say no book well.
We attend parties by the roadside, sitting next to a stinking gutter.
I will come go party when we say we'll sit near gutter.
Here in Lagos.
For this place, for Lagos.
I remember in those days, we used to take mosquito coil along to parties.
I remember in those days, the one who they go party, they carry mosquito call the follow body.
Because as we are eating rice beside the gutter and drinking beer, mosquito is also doing his own business.
Because as they eat rice, they drink beer near gutter, mosquito they do he work for our body.
Now we have plenty of food at home.
We get many food for us.
We had enough to feed a street.
We get money when we say we feed people when they for one street.
But the devil will see, say, go and sit down there.
The devil will see, tell us, say, but go there, man, you go sit down, boo.
By the roadside.
For the roadside near gutter.
We call it partying, enjoying.
We they call that one, say, we enjoy the party.
We go to nightclubs. We do all kinds of horrible things.
We'll go nightclub, go do yeah things there.
And we'll come back and say, when we wake up, we say, oh, yesterday was bad.
We'll come wake up, we'll come say, ah, yesterday bad, well,
but we said it with pride.
But we talk this all with anger.
We wake up with head banging, and we grab another bottle of alcohol.
We will wake up with strong head tickle. The next thing we'll go do, we'll carry one bottle of alcohol to drink.
And we say, it is a curse that you use to cure a curse.
We're going to say that curse now you tell the cure curse.
How many of you know what I'm talking about?
How many of you know what you are they talk about?
Pretend that you don't understand.
More than they pretend so you don't understand what you are they talk.
It's absolutely all right.
Well, is it okay?
They brought a blind man to Jesus Christ, but he didn't remain blind.
They carry one man when he said, no, they see, come to Jesus Christ. But that man, no, he not remain, say, he not they see.
They brought us to Jesus Christ, we were blind.
They carry on come meet Jesus Christ, we know they see.
But now, thank God, we can see.
But thank God, now we they see well.
In John chapter 9, verses 24 and 25.
For John chapter 9, verse 24, go reach 25.
John 9, 24 and 25.
John 9, 24, go reach 25.
That blind man said, whether Jesus is a sinner or not, I don't know.
That blind man, when the Bible talks, say whether Jesus Christ is a person they sin or not they sin, I don't know that one. No.
One thing I know. Once I was blind, now I see.
The one thing when I know, before I was blind, but now they see well.
These are the kind of testimonies I gave to my fellow lecturers in the university in those days when they said to me, what's wrong with you?
Now, this kind of testimony I tell those people when they follow me, they teach for university. When I say, what did they worry you?
We were doing this thing together.
Now, all of us, they do this here thing together now.
And when they begin to talk about Jesus Christ, they say, well, was a good teacher, but don't call him the Son of God.
When they try to talk about Jesus Christ, they say, Jesus Christ, that person will be saying no how to teach you, but may you not call him the King of God.
Might be in heaven, he's minding his business, I'm minding my own business.
If he's there, heaven, they mind his own business. So me, are they here, they mind my own business.
Well, and they said to me, what make you say?
They'll come ask me, say, what it come make you when you to say you don't deceive?
That is different. Because we used to make fun of him together. I say,
when can make you do different? Because all of us, they hear the name of Jesus Christ.
I can assure you of one thing.
I'll tell you, I say, if you tell you of one thing, no.
Once I was blind, now I see.
Before I was blind, but now I don't see well.
They brought a blind man to him, and he received his sight.
They can carry one man when they see, come with Jesus Christ. After that, he can't see well.
Those your relatives who are still visiting herbalists, who are still smoking and drinking, they are blind, bring them to Jesus.
Those your brothers and sisters and friends when we say they see they visit Babalawo house, they see they drink, they see they smoke, they're blind, bring them come meet Jesus Christ.
So you can open their eyes.
So you can open their eyes.
Point number three.
The point number three. Oh,
they brought him to Jesus. Not to the disciples.
They cannot come give Jesus Christ. They cannot come give the disciples. Oh.
Not to the high priest.
Not be the high priest. They cannot come give.
Not to anyone else, but to Jesus.
They cannot come give another person, but now Jesus Christ they cannot come give.
They brought him to the one that can do what no human being can do.
The kind is blind man can't give person when they say go feed do what any other person not go feed do.
They brought him to the Savior. Who can save?
Hekaya come give the person and be say go fit save.
Matthew chapter 1 verse 21
to say,
"Shall call his name Jesus, for he shall save his people from their sins."
Say they will call his name Jesus Christ because he will save everybody from their sins.
No man can save.
Nobody feels save.
Except Jesus Christ. Only Jesus can save.
Now only Jesus Christ feels save.
The Bible says there is no other name given among men.
The Bible to say not give any man any name
whereby we might be saved.
What will feel conte save?
They brought him to the great physician.
That can I can't give you person and be say Sabia to treat person.
Exodus 15 verse 26. They brought him to the one who said, "I am the Lord that healeth thee."
They can't come give the person when to say, "Now maybe the God when we say they heal you."
They knew they could not heal this man.
They no say they're not going to heal this man.
It wasn't that he had bad eyesight.
Don't be say yeah, bad. Say you know they see well. Though.
He was blind.
But this man, you know they see at all.
Totally blind.
This man, you know they see at all.
No doctor could help him any further.
No doctor though. When be say go fit help this man. When be say they're blind.
But they brought him to the one who created heaven and earth.
The God can't give the person when be say now he create heaven and earth.
The one who made eyes.
The person when be say now he himself make the eyes.
They brought him to the healer.
They bring and can't give that person when go feel heal him.
They brought him to the great deliverer.
The God can't give the person when be say go feel deliver him from every katakata when he day.
The one who according to John 18:36.
The one we talk for John 18:36.
John 18:36. When the Son sets you free, you are free indeed.
Because when Jesus Christ does set you free, you are already there free.
I have seen some people who were mad before and were taken to psychiatric hospitals.
And I see people when me say they're not crazy before and they can't carry and go to hospital when they take care of Chris.
And then the doctor sent them home and said they are okay now. And when you look at them, you will know that there is a fire underneath.
And later the doctor can send them go out, say they're not okay. But when you look at these people, you'll see small crazy for their eyes.
That are being kept under control.
You see and say the crazy still deal, but now it's not under control.
And they tell him, "Don't stop taking your drugs. Keep taking your drugs."
They tell him, "Say, make you not stop till they take this your drugs. So I beg, they still they take them all."
But when Jesus wants to set the captives free, he speaks a word to all the demons, "Go," and they go.
But when Jesus Christ wants to set that person, when he said, "I put for bondage free," now only one word you talk, say, "Go," and all the demons they go.
And the man becomes completely whole again.
And the person will come there well again.
Bring your people to Jesus.
Carry all your friends and your brother and sister come give Jesus Christ.
He will save them, he will heal them, he will deliver them.
He will save them, he will heal them, he will deliver them.
He will meet all their needs.
Everything they want, he will give them.
He will do what you cannot do for them.
He will do that when we say you know if he do for them.
The best gift that you can give your relatives or friends at Christmas is Jesus Christ.
The better gift when you feel give your brother and sister or your friends to now Jesus Christ for Christmas time.
Bring them to him.
Amen. Carry them, come give Jesus Christ.
Point number four.
Number four.
He led him out of the city.
He can't carry and come out, go outside the city.
Jesus grabbed the man by the hand and took him out of the city.
Jesus Christ can't hold the man for hand, carry the man, come out from the city.
Some miracles require that you move out.
The first of miracle go happen, you're supposed to go outside.
There are some of you here. You have been in the headquarters for only God knows how long.
Some of you are there many years for this headquarters.
You have heard about the Holy Ghost service. All these years, the Holy Ghost service started in 1986.
When I did you hear about the Holy Ghost service, so where can start from 1986?
Here. Behind me here.
For this place, so for where I stay, so for my back.
Apart from that first one, which you attended because it was conducted here.
Apart from the first one, we say they can't do because now here they hold them.
Some of you have not attended another one.
Some of you have never go any other one.
I can guarantee you now, when we come back in January.
I feel tell you now, when we come back for January.
And we ask how many people did not come to the Holy Ghost Congress?
I will call and say, how many people not come Holy Ghost service for January?
Here at the headquarters, we will see hands going up.
We will see many hands when they go raise up.
If Jesus Christ should return today and he does not land in the city room of some of you.
If Jesus Christ can't come today and he not can't come for the city room of many of you now.
You won't follow him. Go.
Many of you now go follow and go.
What is it that is tying you down?
What if that when we say they tie you for grand?
People are coming from Australia.
Many people will come from Australia.
People are coming from the far east where the sun rises.
Many people will come from the far east where the sun rises.
They are coming from the far west. They are coming from Indonesia.
And they come from far west and they come from Indonesia.
They are coming from Muslim countries. They are coming from all over the world.
Then they come from some Muslim country and then they come from all over the world.
They are coming from Sokoto.
Then they even come from Sokoto.
They are coming from Maiduguri.
Then they come from Maiduguri.
And you are here in Lagos.
And you are there here for Lagos.
To travel from here to kilometer 46.
To go travel from here, go reach kilometer 46.
I will watch it on television.
Well, I go watch it for television.
It is amazing. When you read Mark chapter 10.
It is surprising me when you can read Mark chapter 10.
Verse 46 to 52.
Verse 46 to 52.
Mark 10, 46 to 52.
Mark 10, 46 to 52.
That it was outside Jericho that Bartimaeus got his miracle.
You see, I say now, outside Jericho, now Bartimaeus can't get his miracle.
It was outside the city.
Now outside the city they,
there are some miracles that happen outside the city.
Some miracle there when be saying that only outside the city if it happen.
That requires an extra effort on your part. Move out.
You need to do something extra to get that miracle. I bet may you come outside.
When you read Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 to 3.
When you read Genesis chapter 12, verse 1 to 3.
Genesis 12, verse 1 to 3.
Genesis 12, 1, go reach 3.
God said to Abraham, before I can do the miracles I want to perform in your life, you have to get out.
God can tell Abraham, say, before I go do that better thing for your life, you need to come outside.
I told you, I pray that God will give me a message for you that will make sure your problems are solved before the end of the year.
I don't tell you, I pray, say, may God give me a message, you want to make sure, say, on a problem that they solve before this year will come end.
Some of you will need to go out there and get the miracles.
Many of you will need to go outside there to go get the miracle.
When you listen to the testimonies of what God has been doing at the redemption camp,
where you can listen to the testimony when God will do for people's life for redemption camp.
It is amazing that there are some people who will be living in Lagos and will miss any Holy Ghost night.
You will surprise some people sit there in Lagos when they say go constantly miss Holy Ghost night.
It is amazing.
The thing they surprise me.
But then of course the elders have a saying.
Well, the elders can't get the way that they talk him.
They said the one whose head will sleep in the rain.
He said the person when be saying head now under rain he go sleep.
Even if his house is roofed with corrugated iron sheet.
Even though now better roofing sheet better roofing house.
The rain will still come through the hole made by nails.
He said the rain will still pass through the nail hole constantly meet this person.
Some people who will sleep hungry, even if you give them food, while they are about to eat, the goat will come and snatch it away.
Some people when we say, they don't destine them, say that they go hungry, sleep. Even though when you give them food, you're surprised, say, goat will come take their food, eat them before they know.
I pray that whatever it is that will not allow you to grab your own blessing.
I pray, say that when we say they go allow you, may you collect your own blessing.
God will deal with it today.
God will come deal with that thing today.
If it is laziness,
if not because you're lazy,
if it is a lukewarm attitude, If it is an uncaring attitude,
or you sure don't care attitude,
whatever it is that will allow you to carry your problem to the new year,
we're going to make you go carry your problem go to the new year.
God will deal with it today.
God will deal with it today.
I mean, I remember several of the testimonies.
I remember some of your testimonies.
One of the testimonies that had always amazed me,
the one the OMB said they surprised me,
was that of a bank manager who was working in Ijebu Ode.
Now, about one bank manager when they work for Ijebu Ode,
and ran mental.
And the man come mad.
He became mad.
The man can go mad.
Violently mad.
This man, the madness, serious well.
So mad that, you know, the police had to put handcuffs on his hands, shackles on his feet.
He mad, so say, for police to come and down, the police can handcuff his hand, can use shackles to hold his feet.
And about six policemen were taking him to Arrow.
And as six policemen, now they can, they go, those persons that they treat people when they're mad.
And he said to them, as they were driving, he said, my case is not for the doctor. Take me to redemption camp.
And he can't tell them as they can. They go to this hospital, say, my case, not be doctor, go fi Ando Ramu. Abemona carry me go to the redemption camp.
In his madness, he still remember to say that one.
As he did crazy, so he still remember to talk that one.
So they brought him to the camp, and I was there when they brought him.
They go carry and come camp. Are they there when we say they carry and come?
Shackled hand and feet. In the car,
they put anchor for his hand, put anchors for his leg, and they put her inside car.
And the policeman said, well, this man said, we must bring him here first before we take him to wherever we are taking him.
But the policeman can't tell me, say, this man say, we need to bring her come here first before we can't carry and go anywhere where we won't carry and go.
He said, if he gets here, he'll be healed.
He said, if he reach here, he said, he'll come well.
I said, yeah, in that case, let him come down.
I can't tell you, I say, if not so, let her make him come down now.
They said, no. It's very wild.
They said, no. This man, yes, it's wrong. Go well,
I said, this man told you in his madness.
I can't tell you. I said, this man, he can't tell you now when you're crazy.
If I can step on this ground, I'll be made up.
Say, if I feel put my leg for this campground, I will come well.
Lose him.
I can't tell you. I said, more than lose him now.
They say, okay, will you accept responsibility? I say, I will.
Because if anything happens, now you go all, I tell them, say, Mona, no worry.
They remove his shackles, they remove his handcuffs. He stepped out of the police car as soon as he touched the ground. He was whole.
They can't command the handcuff when they hand, command the shackles when they leg. As he can't put his leg for the campground, at once he can't do well.
I didn't pray for him.
I not pray for Ramu.
I have a witness here.
I get person when we say they there that time when they here.
Pastor Akinide can tell you that he knows the man I'm talking about.
The pastor go fit tell you about the person that they talk about.
When a mad fellow says, get me there, I will receive my miracle.
When person when we say they crazy, say make carry me go there, I go come well.
How come you call yourself sane? And you hear that the Congress is coming, there's Holy Ghost there every month, and you stay at home.
Are you when we say you thought say you did well, and you can't hear say the Congress they come, and with the whole Holy Ghost service every month, and you can't do your house?
Blame me, God.
And you can't blame God.
Occasionally, God expects you to go out of the city.
Once, God won't make you go outside the city.
Just step out of the city.
Make you go outside your city.
And your miracle will be waiting for you there.
And your miracle will be there to wait you.
Then number 5.
Number 5.
The Lord spit on his eyes and then touched him.
Jesus Christ can't spit for this blind man's eyes. He can't touch the man.
Well, if nothing else, at least that tells us that God is a God of variety.
God, that person when we say they do things different way.
Because when you look at the various people that who are blind, take just those who are blind that he healed, you will find that he never repeated himself.
Even I can't take a look of all the people when Jesus Christ healed, you'll find that he not repeat the way he one person healed the other person.
In the case of a man in John chapter 9, verse 1 to 7.
For the case of one man, for John chapter 9, verse 1, go read 7.
John 9, verse 1 to 7.
John chapter 9, verse 1, go read 7.
He spit on the ground, made clay out of it.
He can't spit for sand. He can't make clay out of that one.
And put the mud across his eyes and said, go and wash.
And he can't put this clay where he don't make for the man's eye. I can't tell the man, say, go, may you go wash your eye.
That's one method.
Now, one method be that.
That's the method he chose to use at that time.
Now, that method he chose to use that time.
In dealing with Bartimaeus, in Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to 52.
When you deal with Bartimaeus, for Mark chapter 10, verse 46 to 52.
Mark 10, 46 to 52.
Mark 10, chapter 46, go to 52.
He simply spoke and said to him, receive your sight.
Now, talk to Bartimaeus, say, receive your sight.
God is the Almighty. He does as He pleases.
God not big pass all though. He does do things the way He like.
And He's free to use whatever method that He wants to heal.
He's free to use any method when He wish to use to heal you.
Whatever method.
Any method when He like.
He can do whatever He wants to do the way He wants to do it.
If He do anything, for the way when we say He like to do them.
The way He wants to do it.
The way He likes to do them.
That is why those who are wise, they keep going to Him constantly because they don't know what method He's going to use next.
Now make those people when get sense, they always go meet Jesus Christ because they don't know the pattern when they go use next.
All they know is that somehow He will use one method that will produce a solution for them.
Always they no say any IBO, they no say God will use one particular method when go give them solution of their problem.
Then point number six.
Point number six.
The man looked up and said, I saw men like trees.
The man can't look up, say, I didn't see people like trees.
From day number one, God had always compared men to trees.
From day number one, God started comparing man as trees.
In Genesis chapter 1, verse 28.
For Genesis chapter 1, verse 28.
Genesis 1, verse 28, he said to the first man that he created, he said.
For Genesis chapter 1, verse 28, he can't talk to the first man when he creates. Say,
be fruitful.
He said, make you there fruitful.
It's a tree that bears fruit.
Now, tree, now they bear fruit.
Be fruitful.
Make you there fruitful.
When the Lord was talking in Matthew chapter 7, verse 15 to 20.
From Matthew chapter 7, verse 15 to 20.
Matthew 7, verse 15 to 20.
Matthew chapter 7, verse 15 to 20.
Again, he kept on comparing men to trees.
Again, they compare man to trees.
Bad tree will produce bad fruit.
He said, bad tree, now bad fruit you will produce.
Good trees will produce good fruits.
Good tree, now good fruit you will produce.
By their fruits. You shall know them.
He said, what is the produce now you tell know them?
What's your fruit?
And what is the produce?
Because you are supposed to be a tree, a fruitful tree.
Because it's supposed to be tree. Tree when we say they produce fruit.
When you bring forth fruit, when you win souls, he calls it bringing forth fruit.
When you can't go outside, go bring other people, call me Jesus Christ. So Jesus Christ, they call that one, saying our fruit.
When you produce a child, they call it the fruit of the womb.
When you come born pikin, now the fruit of the womb that they call them.
You are to be a fruitful tree.
He said you're supposed to be tree when they produce fruit.
He said, there is this tree that is just full of leaves and not producing fruit. He said, cut it down.
Get one tree and be saying, yeah, they produce leaves and you know they produce fruit. Jesus Christ said they cut and down.
He was not talking about another tree. He was talking about men.
You know they talk about ordinary tree, not about human being they talk about.
What kind of fruit are you producing?
Which type of fruit do they produce?
Finally, point number seven.
Last, point number seven.
He touched him the second time.
He can't touch him the second time.
That's probably the most profound aspect of this story.
Now this part, now the important part of this story.
Some cases need more than one touch.
Some cases need more than one touch.
Oh yes, they do.
And so they need them.
For example, if you read 1 Kings chapter 17, 1 Kings chapter 17 from verse 17 to the end,
If you can read 1 Kings chapter 17 from 17, go reach the end.
Elijah laid on the son of the widow of Zarephath 3 times.
Elisha can't lie on top of the son of the widow of Zarephath. Now 3 times now I do that thing.
Before the dead child sneezed.
Before the picking widow died, can't sneeze.
And came back to life 3 times.
And he can't come back to life. Now 3 times now Elisha do that thing.
He laid on him the first time, nothing happened.
He's lie on now the first time, nothing happened.
Second time, nothing happened.
The second time he drew him, nothing happened.
Third time, then the child sneezed.
The third time when he can't lie on top of the child, now the picking can't sneeze.
I woke up, all right, 3 times.
The picking can't wake up. At 3 times now Elisha do that one.
If you read 2 Kings chapter 4, from verse 18 to the end.
For 2 Kings chapter 4, verse 18, go reach the end.
2 Kings chapter 4, from verse 18 to the end.
2 Kings chapter 4, verse 18, go reach the end.
Elisha laid on the son of the Shunammite woman 3 times.
Elisha lied on the son of the Shunammite woman 3 times.
First time, nothing happened.
First time, nothing happened.
Second time, nothing happened.
Second time, nothing happened.
Third time, the child came back to life.
After the third time, Onali Pikin can come back to life.
If you read 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1 to 14.
If you can read 2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1, go reach 14.
2 Kings 5, verse 1 to 14.
2 Kings chapter 5, verse 1, go reach 14.
Naaman dipped himself 7 times.
Naaman, on 7 times, he dipped himself inside the river.
First time, nothing happened.
First time, nothing happened.
Second time, nothing happened.
Second time, nothing happened.
Fifth time, nothing. Sixth time, nothing.
The fifth time, nothing happened. The sixth time, nothing happened.
Seventh time.
The seventh time, something could happen.
What's this telling you?
What did this one tell you?
Keep asking till your joy is full.
Make you continue to the answer until your joy come plenty.
Some of you will pray only once. And then you, and that's enough.
Some of you, and only one time when I will pray and you say, that was all rich, bro.
God is not your house boy.
Almighty God not be your house boy, you.
You can't tell him this is the way you must solve my problem.
You never feel tell us, and I saw you go solve my problem.
I'm going to pray for 1 hour. If you don't answer me 1 hour, then.
After I don't pray for 1 hour, then.
Then what?
Then waiting.
You arrest God?
You can't arrest God.
Who needs a miracle? Is it God or you?
Now who can't need miracle? Now God have been at you.
Bible says pray without ceasing. Just keep on, until you get your answer.
Bible says make you pray without you not stop. Just they keep on, they pray until you can't get your answers.
That's one lesson to learn from the second touch.
Now one lesson when we say you need to learn from the second touch.
Another lesson to learn from the second touch was that the very first touch produced a miracle.
Another lesson when we say you need to learn from the second touch, we say the first touch when Jesus Christ touched the man produced miracle.
The man couldn't see anything before.
The man never see anything before.
But now when he got the first touch, he could see men like trees.
When Jesus Christ can't touch him the first time, if he can't see men as trees.
Yeah, well, they look like trees. But they were men.
They look like trees, though, but now human be they be.
He didn't say he saw goats.
He not say now goats I see.
Something was already happening in his life.
So thing that they happen for a life.
But the second touch brought perfection. Everything became perfect.
But the second touch, the perfect thing now he can't do for a life. Everything about the man's life can't be perfect.
When you go through the scriptures, you will discover several people who received a second touch.
When you can't go through the scripture, you can't see many people when we say they get the second touch.
A second touch.
The second touch.
A second touch. And things changed.
They get the second touch and things can't change for their life.
Take Elisha.
No, we can take Elisha as an example.
The first time he received a touch was in 1 Kings chapter 19, verse 19 to 21.
The first touch when he received now, 1 Kings chapter 19, from 19 go reach 21.
1 Kings 19, verse 19 to 21.
1 Kings chapter 19, verse 19 go reach 21.
He was plowing and Elijah was passing by and took his mantle and threw it on him.
He did do a farm work as Elisha they passed. Elisha can't carry clothes. God threw him on top of Elijah.
From that day on, he ceased to be a farmer. He became a servant of the prophet of God.
From that day onward, Elisha shall not be farmer again, no, a servant he can be of the prophet of God.
But by the time we go to 2 Kings chapter 2, verse 9 to 15.
By the time we come reach 2 Kings chapter 2, from 9 go reach 15.
2 Kings chapter 2, verse 9 to 15.
2 Kings chapter 2, verse 9 go reach 15.
The mantle fell on him a second time.
The mantle come fall on top of him the second time.
And my, oh my, Elisha became the most powerful prophet.
I feel tell you now, Elisha later come be the prophet when get power past all of them.
Of the Old Testament.
Of the Old Testament.
The first time he got a touch, he was a servant of the prophet.
The first time when we say he get a touch, now servant of the prophet now he be.
The second time he got a touch, he became the father of all prophets.
The second time when we say he can't get a touch, now papa of all prophets now he can't be.
Second touch.
Second touch.
Peter, on the day of Pentecost.
Peter, for the days of Pentecost.
Acts chapter 2, verse 1 to 4.
Acts chapter 2, verse 1 to 4.
Acts 2, 1 to 4.
Acts 2, chapter 1, go reach 4.
Peter got the first touch.
Peter got the first touch.
The Holy Spirit came. Became like cloven tongues of fire.
The Holy Spirit can't come upon them. Come like small fire on top of their heads.
Sat on top of everybody. Sat on Peter too.
He's there on top of all their head. Even Peter's head, he's there on top of him also.
He got the first touch.
He got the first touch.
And he began to speak in tongues.
And he got to speak another tongue.
Some days later, Acts chapter 3. Verse 1 to 8.
After some days, though, for Acts chapter 3, verse 1, go reach 8.
Acts 3, verse 1 to 8.
Acts chapter 3, verse 1, go reach 8.
He was going to the church and he saw a lame man. He said, "Hey, lame man, in the name of Jesus Christ, rise up and walk." The man didn't move.
He negotiates church one day and he can't see one man, one of you walk. And he can't say, "Man, one of you walk, get up, may you walk." The man of not move at all.
But he grabbed him by the hand.
May he can't use the hand to drag this man stand up.
And the power that he got on the day of Pentecost flowed through him to the man.
And the power he got for the days of Pentecost will come flow through his hand to this man.
And the man got up and began to walk.
And this man called his start to the worker.
Jump, praising God.
They jump, they praise God.
Then, in Acts chapter 4, verse 31.
For Acts chapter 4, verse 31.
Acts 4. Verse 31.
Acts 4, verse 31.
Peter and the disciples were together again and they prayed.
Peter and the other disciples, they did together again and they come to pray.
And the Holy Spirit came the second time.
And the Holy Spirit come the second time.
This time, when he came the second time, he shook the house.
This time, when the Holy Spirit come, he can't shake the house. Well.
When Peter got that second touch,
when Peter can't get the second touch.
By the time you go to Acts chapter 5, verse 14 to 16.
For Acts chapter 5, verse 14, go read 16.
Acts 5, 14 to 16.
Acts 5, verse 14, go read 16.
Peter did not need to touch anybody again before they got healed.
Peter did not need to touch anybody again before the person will come receive the healing.
His shadow alone was enough to do the work.
The shadow of Peter, now they do the work.
The second touch is the perfecting touch.
The second touch should not be the touch when we say the finished work.
It's the touch that makes perfect everything that concerns anybody.
Now they make everything that concerns anybody complete.
And if there's any prayer you should pray today.
If any prayer there when we say you go pray today.
If you want God to perfect that which concerns you.
If you want God, may God complete that when we say consign you.
Is that he should give you another touch.
Now say, may God come touch you the second time.
Some of us, only one thing remains in our life to make our joy full.
Many of us, only one thing that remains for us to make our joy come plenty.
That one thing can be handled today.
That one thing, God will handle that today.
By a second touch.
By the second touch.
From the Almighty God.
From the Almighty God.
Some of us are well. We are healthy.
Many of us, we're well, our body, they kakaraka.
No sickness, No problem at all.
No sickness there, but you will not get any problem at all.
Problem probably is we don't have enough money.
But the problem won't fit get fit be say we not get plenty money
to meet all our needs.
To come solve all the problem what we get.
A second touch can take care of that.
Second touch you go fit handle that one.
Some of us, we have no problem physically, we have no problem materially, we are healthy.
Many of us, so we will not get problem when they see, we do not get any problem when we say, consign money.
The only problem is that we've been believing God for a future partner.
But the only problem we get is say, we will believe God for who we will marry.
A second touch can solve that problem.
The second touch fee under that problem.
Some of us are married, we only believe in God for the fruit of the womb. A second touch can solve that problem.
Many of us don't marry, but they believe God for the fruit of the womb. The second touch, go fit solve that problem.
But some of us are married, we have children, but they are all girls, and we want a boy.
Many of us don't marry, we get children, but all of them are girls, and we want boy.
The second touch can solve that problem.
The second touch fit solve that problem.
Some of us, we have no problems at all.
Some of us will not get problem at all.
All we want is that we want to be closer to the Almighty God. We want to be the best that any human being can be for God.
Always we want be say we want to be close to God. We won't be the best when we say anybody will fit be for God.
A second touch can take care of that. Let's stand on our feet.
A second touch fit do that one. I bet we'll stand up.
Now some of you who have not even received the first touch, you have not yet surrendered your life to Jesus Christ.
Many of you are there when we say, no, I get the first touch, you are not giving a life to Jesus Christ.
You better come, because you can't talk of a second touch if you haven't received the first one.
You better come, because you know if you talk about the second touch, when you be saying, you know if you get the first one.
If you have not given your life to Jesus Christ, come forward now, come and surrender your life to Him.
If you never give your life to Jesus Christ, come now, you can give your life to Jesus Christ.
The rest of us, I want us to lift our voice to the Almighty God.
The remaining of us, I want us to come carry our voice, go give to the Almighty God.
First of all, I want you to bless Him that He has even brought you thus far.
The first thing one I want to do, I'm going to thank God. Say, God, thank you for how far you don't bring me reach here.
And then call on Him and say, Father, touch me again.
And may you call on Him. May you say, Papa, I better touch me today.
Perfect that which concerns me.
Everything will concern me, may you complete Him.
Don't let me take any problem to the new year.
I beg you don't let me carry any problem when we say that my body go the new year.
Touch me again.
I beg you touch me again.
If you want to give your life to Jesus, come forward and come and talk to the Lord and ask Him to save your soul.
If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, may you come forward. May you come tell and say, Papa God, I beg save my soul.
God bless you, my sister. You begin to talk to the Almighty and ask Him to be merciful unto you.
God bless you, my sister. May you begin to tell God Almighty, say, I beg, sorry for me.
And to save your soul.
I beg, may you save my soul.
Anyone else who wants to give his or her life to Jesus, come on now.
Anybody there and be say want to give your life to Jesus Christ, may you come now.
The Lord is waiting for you.
The Almighty God will wait for you.
The very first touch is the touch of salvation.
The first touch you need to get to is the touch of salvation.
Come. Come and give your life to Him.
Come, may you come give your life to Jesus Christ.
And He will save your soul today.
And He will come save your soul today.
So the rest of us, let's bless His holy name for bringing us thus far.
The remaining of us, more bless the name of the Lord Jesus Christ for bringing us this far.
And then call on Him. Father,
and may you come tell, say, Papa,
perfect that which concerns me today.
May you complete that thing which concerns me today.
Give me yet another touch.
I beg, may you touch me the second time.
Give me a second touch today.
I beg, give me a second touch today.
If you want to give your life to Jesus, come on now.
If you want to give your life to Jesus Christ, come now.
The Lord is waiting.
Jesus Christ will wait for you.
He's waiting to save your soul.
He will wait to come save your soul. Your soul. Your soul. Your soul. Your soul. Your soul.